Okay, dear students, today we are going to discuss about ethnography. This ethnography is a study covering about understanding the people by going to their community, living along with them, and observing them very closely with their way of standard of living, with their culture, their behavior, their way of negotiating with the products what they are having, and also where the need for them to have a different type of services or facilities, which in turn helps them to improve their standard of living. Okay, with this preface, what is this ethnography? It is a science which is about qualitative method, where this is being utilized by the people to understand the people who are living in the areas where a lot of development is not happened, and like tribal groups, are also the people who are physically challenging or mentally challenging, and when you'd like, are the people who are not in this the cultural environment, to make a study on that particular people and trying to understand them and making a report on those people. That is something which is named as an ethnography. So after a certain time period of implementation of this ethnography, the designers understood the importance of this, and they felt that this particular study will definitely make them to bring the products, bring the services, which makes people to appreciate the services which are going to be delivered to them. Okay, so here the observer or a person who is going to understand the behavior, the culture, the needs of the people by going and staying along with them for longer time and becoming a part of them and trying to see how they are able to live, how they are able to do activities, either by observing while doing, either by recording what they are doing it, or by interacting with them about their entire the behavior in their real time environment. So the aim of doing this particular thing is to understand the design problem very in depth. That is the thing what is named as to get under the skin of a design problem. So through this ethnography, the designer can get deeper understanding of the problem, including the domain where we are going to apply, and also the people, and also process, goals, and the application context. A designer is going to be truly understanding the problem. If he understands the problem, definitely he can be in a position to give a better solution to that particular problem, what he has perceived. So there are methods which are associated with this ethnography, where the person who is going there as a learner need to be there long-term live and work approach, which will make him to get opportunity to understand the people or the customers in a very closer way by interacting with them, by participating in their activities, by observing them, by understanding in every aspect how they are. Not necessary to be like providing them awareness about I am reading, I am observing you people, I am trying to make some sort of report on you people. Instead of either, of course, this could be happening either through getting the permission from them to study about them, or unknowingly studying that. It is something called as a overt and covert approaches, which could be used for this ethnography. And these ethnographic studies will be definitely useful for these user-centered projects. So most of the cases, these studies will be applicable for the participant observation, the interviews, and the surveys. So in ethnographic research, there are many varieties of information which could be gathered. One is about observational research, whatever you are able to see in front of you through your naked eyes, and similarly visual anthropology, surveys and questionnaires, focus groups, literature review, and also photo ethnographies. The procedure it follows, like, first you require to identify the research question, and then you require to determine what problem that you are seeking to better understand, and make a statement from that particular understanding what you acquired, and trying to raise the questions relevant to that particular statement. Okay, and thereafter you have to identify what are the topics that you are going to be addressing the people in that environment to make them to be better to have their relationships, their culture, their interactions and process, whatever. Then try to identify the locations of research. Once after identifying the research question, you require to find out whom you wanted to keep under your study and how you are going to gather the information from them. So it could be not necessary to be in a single location. It may be in multiple locations. When you wanted to have like a diversified ideas from a different groups. Okay, so this particular thing is going to be the second stage where you need to identify the locations for research and the people, and how do you make your approach of reaching them. It is again formulation of presentation method. So considering the most effective ways for getting the objective information from the group of people, we may have to become as a person in that community or organization and observing them, or you may become like the person who has been informed to them that, okay, I am doing some research, I need to collect some data, which in turn will be utilized for me by me for doing this product development or something like that. So you require to say, how do you go and present your information to them? Either you are going to contact through some nodal people, and from there you are going to get access, or you may be going directly or talking to the very extrovert people among the community and trying to communicate them and getting access to study about their particular group of people. And then suppose if it is essential, you may have to get the permissions and the access, right? So that it's, this particular study is not supposed to be questioned by a people if any privacy issues comes into picture. So for that reason, we require to keep ready with the permissions and accesses, and thereafter you need to go and again participate in that particular role. The participation is going to be observing the people when they are making their lifestyle, when they are following their lifestyle, when they are undergoing their own behavioral the pattern, and keeping that particular thing not to be disturbed, at the same time observing them, noting down them, and keeping that to be as a reference for your further studies thereafter. So the most effective ways of collecting the notes is going to be like a field notes, or which could be taken directly by recording, or it could be like survey relevant things or interactions directly. Whatever the way is possible, you could do it like interviews. It could be do like the way the person to person interactions, and trying to make everyone to be get involved and again able to give like a right information what could be utilized by you in a better way. After collecting all these informations and all, you will be making out as a data which could be utilized by you to make it as a proper representation of collected information. Either it could convert in the form of empathy map, or it could be converted in the form of journey map, or it could be converted in the form of storyboarding. Whatever the way it is possible, you could work out like how do you represent this data to your team members to develop the better tools for them. So when this particular ethnography will be more useful to do it, means it is at the early stages of the development of the product, because that is a place where you can take a proper decisions to incorporate by understanding the inputs, right? And thereafter, if you are able to apply it, the product or the service what you are going to develop, it definitely will be able to satisfy the needs of the people whom you study. And also these particular ethnographic methods may also be applied for the product which is already been used, that is about like when the participants, how they are working on that particular product and how they are using it, the tasks can be observed and which will make the designers to go for the next level products to be developed. Right. So the main advantage of this ethnography is like having a very direct access to this culture and practices of the group. Of course, there is ample chances for the people to get a first hand about the behavior and interaction of the people. And also they feel like immersed in a social environment where they can get authentic information spontaneously, a chance to observe dynamics, and helps in identifying and analyzing the unexpected issues. And also they'll have like a detailed and faithful representation of users' behavior and attitudes. The disadvantages of this ethnography is, main thing is it demands more commitment, more time usage. At the same time, if any the permissions or the approvals are essential to be taken to conduct this type of ethnography. And if the time what you are taken, if it is becoming it too much, then the need for developing the product also may become like obsolete. Okay, so sometimes what happened, this the way of like, you know, observing the people, initially when you're introducing the product newly, they may feel like a very supportive and, you know, information is required to make them to start from scratch. But once after completion of around the exposure of this same new product for a week or a month or something, depending upon the complexity of the product, thereafter the user starts finding out different shortcuts and workarounds so that he may not be following the procedure which has been prescribed in the initial condition. He will try to go for cutting down the steps in between, and he will try to catch up in order to save his time. So for that reason, when we are trying to develop a product, it's better to have it like a different level of competencies of the users also, where in turn the people, when they are getting into the advanced level, and they can directly have a different mode of entry, different mode of access, which also could be studied and learned from this ethnography. That in turn makes the people to have like a different kinds of people based on their technical level and competency level. Okay. So as we discussed, this ethnography is a qualitative research and also the flexible research method, which will be sometimes will be made it as the called way, based on its reports, and sometimes based on the study what we do it. Okay. And there are approaches which are followed by the people when they're conducting ethnography. It could be like open ethnography study or closed ethnography study. And as we discussed about overt ethnography study or covert ethnography study or active ethnography study or passive ethnography study. So here the difference is going to be like active and passive means the person who has gone for observing the people. If he is going to be immersed in a full extent, he can go and again participate as if like the other, the community, how it is behaving, and he will become as a part of them, and he will try to either whatever the activities are participated by them, they also will get involved and again try to do it. Passive means keeping himself little away from the people and again trying to observe every minute details of them, and not willing to miss out any important occasion, right, where maybe missed out with recording the item and all. So for that reason, all these type of variety of the approaches are there in ethnography, which in turn has to benefit the researcher or like a marketing guy or the person who wanted to understand the customer needs to have a better study about the people who are in need of change in their lifestyle. And that's the way how it happens in ethnography study. Okay, with this presentation, I'll close this about this ethnography studies, and we'll see how it could be.